guys so much for joining this afternoon's lightning talk about the art and science of prompting. My name is Allison Genesta. I'm a senior product marketing manager for Copilot and Copilot Lab. And I'm joined here today with my colleague, Stephanie Torres.
Hi, everyone. I'm Stephanie Torres. I'm also a senior product marketing manager on Copilot. Before we jump in, I know we've got a little crowd here. I want to do a little gauge of the room. By show of hands, do anyone of you consider yourselves prompting experts? It's okay if not, because that's why you're here. So good job. You're in the right place. I ask that because there's a bit of a misconception about prompting that you have to be a prompting engineer or an expert in prompting to prompt with Copilot, and you don't. But the more skill set that you have with prompting will help to refine and tailor your output. So we are going to share 3 tips to help elevate your prompting skills. And then Allison is going to run through some live demos to show the Copilot prompts in action. Well, thank you. Okay. All right. So step one, tell Copilot what you need. It all starts with the goal. What do you want Copilot to do? Copilot can help you with lots of tasks. So there's 6 tasks here. These are very popular tasks. And this is just the starting point of what Copilot can help you do. It can help you learn about projects and concepts. If I get added to a new project and I want to be quickly up to speed, I can ask for a status update on that project. The beauty of Copilot is that it's grounded in your business data and it understands your context of you within your organization. So by asking about Project X, it's going to scan all my files, my meetings, my chats, and pull that relevant information in. It can edit text. If I want to refine or rewrite something, it can edit it for me. It can transform documents. It can turn an FAQ into a 10-slide onboarding deck in seconds, which is amazing. It can summarize information. If I'm late to a meeting and I miss something, I can ask Copilot what I missed in the meeting or to summarize what I missed. It can create engaging content. You don't have to start from zero with Copilot. It can help be your creative brainstorming partner and come up with ideas. It can help you catch up on missed items too. So if you're out for a week, we all know that feeling, you're catching up, you've been out for a whole week and you've got a million emails, it can give you a summary of all your emails and what you missed and help you understand what action items you need to work on. So that's number one. We need to tell Copilot what to do, our goal. Then we want to include the right prompt ingredients. So again, this starts with the goal. That's all you really need, honestly. Goal. What do you want Copilot to give you? In this example, generate 3 to 5 bullet points. Perfectly fine to use that as a prompt. But the more that you build, the more context you give, the more tailored the response is going to be. So if we start with the goal, let's add some context. What's it for? We know it's for this meeting with Client X on this brand campaign. What's the source? Because it's grounded in your business data, we can reference certain sources. So I wanted to focus on email and Teams chat since June. And lastly, what other expectations? Do you want it in a certain tone or format? The more detail you give, the more tailored your response. And again, you don't need all of these ingredients, but the more that you add, the better the output and the response. Okay, so we've told Copilot what we need. We've got our ingredients. Now let's look side by side at these two prompts. Prompt number one, nothing wrong with it. Write a blog post about sustainable practices in agriculture. And then prompt number two, we're using those prompt ingredients we just talked through. Now, which one do we think is going to have the more tailored answer? Yes, number two. Nothing wrong with prompt one. It will still give you a response. But prompt number two is going to give you what you're looking for. It's going to give you the context. It's going to be tailored to your situation, your unique business need and situation. So if we want to go to the next slide, this last step. So we've told Copilot what we need. We've got our prompt ingredients. Keep the conversation going. So to interact with Copilot, you just use natural language. The way I like to think about it is it's like a colleague or an intern that just started to work for me. You have to give context to this. If you have an intern start, you can't just tell them, go do this, and they'll know where it is. You got to give them context. What do we want to reference for? This is a source file you should use. You want to give more detail. So use natural language to interact with Copilot, give it context, and keep the conversation going. It's iterative. So even if you start with just the goal, maybe you're new to prompting, you're not very comfortable. I definitely start with this. I know Allison and I have been in the same boat. You just start with a goal. You can build on it. You can respond. It's a follow-up conversation. Summarize this meeting. Gives you an answer. And then I can say, okay, Allison said something about prompting, but I can't remember what it was. What did Allison say about this? It'll give me an answer. What are my action items? The point is keep iterating. You can follow up. And the more you follow up, the more tailored your response is going to be. So those are our 3 steps. Tell Copilot what you need, get your prompt ingredients together, and keep the conversation going. Lastly, just some helpful hints to keep in mind. So Copilot does have limitations. It's limited to your current conversation. So again, the more context, the more detail you give, the better your responses will be. You also, one thing that I like to use is quotation marks. So if you want it to rewrite something or reference a specific part of content, then you can use quotation marks to identify that. So I use that a lot. And one that I also use a lot is starting fresh. So if I've been working on that blog post and I've gone back and forth iterating on chat with it, and I'm ready to switch tasks, maybe I want it to catch me up on something else, I just type in new chat and it helps me start fresh. So now that we've walked through our three helpful tips and some helpful hints, Allison's going to show the real fun stuff, the live demo of it in action.
All right. So let me give a little bit of background. As I mentioned before, I have been using Microsoft 365, Copilot of Microsoft 365 for just over a year now in my day-to-day work. It has completely transformed the way that I work. Adopting some of the tips and tricks that Stephanie just shared has been fundamental on my journey to be a better Copilot prompter. But as Stephanie mentioned before, you don't have to be an expert for this. You just have to keep iterating and constantly experimenting with Copilot to get what you need. One of the places that I use Copilot most in my day-to-day is Teams. I'm a product marketing manager, and oftentimes I'm tasked with managing various projects and product launches all at the same time. This is an example of a meeting that I had about a product launch called Project Atlas. And amongst a pile of emails and meetings and files, using Copilot in Teams really helps me get caught up to speed quickly. Thinking about the things that we just talked about with prompt fundamentals, I wanted to show you some examples of the types of Copilot prompts that I'm using in my day-to-day to unlock the full potential of Copilot. Stephanie, or my manager, for example, had asked me for a really quick summary. How did this meeting go last week, Friday? I had so many meetings that I needed to figure out from Copilot what exactly I missed. So again, being really specific in this example at the top, if you're here with Copilot, summarizing what this meeting is about, that's the goal, right? Being super clear, super crisp on what is that task that I want Copilot to do. But just adding a little bit more context, I needed a one-sentence summary. This helped to make sure that Copilot was responding aligned with the expectations of what I needed. And as you can see, it has the response right there. As Stephanie also mentioned before, it really is truly a conversation. It is okay to ask Copilot questions the same way that you would ask an intern questions or your manager questions. So here's an example of how I'm prompting with Copilot just like that. I asked about what were the important decisions that were made, and it's able to really summarize those really clearly for me. I oftentimes always cross-reference and check Copilot's work. And you can see that with these references, you're able to see exactly where in the transcript Copilot was able to pull up that information. I did see here that we did make a decision last Friday to delay the launch of Project Atlas by 2 weeks. And so that's a big deal, right? I'm getting questions from my manager. What's the reason why we had the delay? There were a lot of stakeholders in the room. I really couldn't really think through. I would have had to go back to think about that. So here's a really great example of a prompt where you can use Copilot to help you reason over the transcript, reason over all of the things that were discussed in that meeting to be able to list out very succinctly the pros and cons. I will say this is one of the best things and why we call it our assistant at work, because it's able to do that harder thinking that would have taken me minutes, if not, 10, 20 minutes to achieve. So really big value in that. Just by also including specific details, like putting it in a table, because that's something that I like to see this presented as, makes it super clean, super easy for me to then share this out with my stakeholders, for example. So again, as we're building off, there's not necessarily a right or wrong. Being conversational in the way you interact with Copilot, but being specific is definitely a key to success. Now I'm going to segue over to the Copilot experience that I actually use the most in my day-to-day. This is Copilot for Microsoft 365 on the web. I love this experience because it's a centralized place where Copilot helps me achieve a lot of complex tasks without me needing to switch from app to app to be able to get that work done. So I see it truly as like the central place. I always have it pulled up on the web, and I use it daily. One of the things that I wanted to share is that, especially if you're new to Copilot and you're new to prompting, It automatically surfaces up a number of different suggested prompts that you can use, all powered by Copilot Lab. And this has been a really useful way for those new users to help with onboarding and just seeing what's possible with Copilot so that they can get started. You can also see that you can see a list of suggested prompts powered by Copilot Lab here. So again, just opening the door, window of opportunity about what's possible with Copilot. This example, using Project Atlas as an example, I really want to know what's the latest on this project, because I'm being asked for an update of basically anything. So in sparing the time of me having to type this out, I have all of my prompts listed here. But here's an example of, again, a really succinct prompt where I'm asking Copilot a question, and I'm wanting to make sure that it's pulling in all of the context and information around Project Atlas based on all of my data in the Microsoft Graph, and that would include my emails, my meetings, and any files associated with Project Atlas. Okay, and just like that, Copilot was really able to be super clear in generating the exact response that I asked for. I asked it to organize everything about Project Atlas, organized by emails, meetings, and files. And this has been so helpful for me in my role as a product manager when I'm really needing to just have a centralized place where I'm able to get a quick update whenever somebody's asking me for one. Again, as I shared before in the Teams example, it's important that you're also looking at the sources. So it does a really great job of pulling in exactly where that information is coming from. So it has all of the Outlook emails that I've received here. It has that meeting transcript that I just showed everybody, that Project Atlas launch from last week. And it even has files that are specific to the launch review that we had in that meeting. So again, best practice, always cross-reference and double-check Copilot's work using those references and those sources. Great. So now I know one of the things that I need to do is send a weekly update to my group of stakeholders. And without skipping a beat, I'm able to do just that directly in the Copilot web experience. So here we have another prompt, and the key goal here is to generate a recap. Something that used to take me minutes to parse through a meeting recording, having to listen, what did they say, what did they do, all of this. Now everything can happen in this centralized place and destination. Really being specific in what I want Copilot to pull into this response, I asked it to list all of the people that attended that meeting, the key decisions that were made in that meeting, and any action items. And then again, it's able to do that with precise detail. So you can see that it's also listed all the meetings. It's also, again, in a different experience, surfacing up those key decisions from that meeting that we touched on before about the launch being delayed by 2 weeks. And then it lists out clearly any of the action items that I can now go back to my stakeholders and inform them, hey, this is what we talked about. I often will take this, copy paste this, and then send this out to a Teams chat. Everybody's aware of what needs to happen. Lastly, since I know that delaying a product launch is a pretty big deal, I want to make sure that I'm now using Copilot to save me time and creating an email that would have probably taken me a good 20 to 30 minutes to build out. So here I am going to ask Copilot to help me get started on that first draft of this email. Again, pulling in all of the context and all of the data around the reasons why we delayed this launch. I also asked it to pull in something that I had received with a customer opportunity. So again, it's able to pull in exactly what I'm needing to articulate in that email and get to work. If we wanted, just an example, if we would wanted this to be shorter, I know there were some examples earlier with our Jeff Tepper keynote, I often will use it, let's be more casual, let's be more succinct. And those are, again, examples of being a little bit more specific in case you did want something that was a little bit shorter or concise. For me, this is a really great first draft. I'm able to then take this information and refine it as I needed to without having to sift through all of the information that I needed to do to be able to generate this recap from scratch. So big plus to Copilot there. The last thing I wanted to share is an example of how I've been using Copilot in more creative ways to work better with my team and with my manager. So we recently had a team offsite, and I'm part of a new team right now, and we had completed a strength builder assessment to identify different strengths on the team and how we can work better together. So we each had our own report, and I was like, can I use Copilot to help me figure out a better way to work with my colleagues based on this doc, on these strengths? So here's an example. And again, this is something that is in my saved chat, but I liked it so much, I wanted to make sure that I presented it to everybody here, just so you guys can also start thinking out of the box on ways that you can use Copilot in your day-to-day. I really like this example because it's a more complex prompt that I wouldn't normally think to write at the beginning of my Copilot journey. Now that I'm feeling a little bit more up to speed, I'm starting to get a little bit more sophisticated in how I'm asking Copilot to do these tasks. I start out by talking about I'm working with a new manager. Again, using natural language and really having a conversation with Copilot the same way that you would be talking to somebody in person. Using the two documents below, these two PDFs that I had uploaded, I asked it to achieve three tasks all in the same prompt. The first task was, what are the tips for working more effectively with Daniel, my manager? The second task that I'm asking it to do are, what are some blind spots that I have that Daniel may be able to help me with? And thirdly, what collective blind spots might we have that I should be mindful of? Again, if I step back, this would actually be really hard for me to think through as a person. Like, if somebody asked me this, I would actually struggle with this. But Copilot was able to leverage this information from those two documents and has really opened the door for me to think about new ways to work with my manager, Daniel, and outline his strengths. So yes, all that being said, I just wanted to share those really great examples on unique ways that you can also not just talk to Copilot, but unlock value from Copilot in ways that are a little bit more out of the box than just, you know, typical daily work tasks that you have at hand. Okay, I'm actually gonna end with a quick slide on this. So we have a talk on Thursday about Copilot Lab. I had shared an update about Copilot Lab. I'm part of the Copilot Lab team. Jesus, right over there, is our group product manager. And we're really excited to be able to learn from each and every one of you about sort of your journey with prompting and prompt fundamentals. I will say, if you are a new user for Copilot, highly recommend that you reference the Copilot Lab site. I had shared with you that this is also integrated throughout the entire Copilot Lab experience. We're here to answer any additional questions, and thank you so much for your time today. Thank you.